Hi everyone, welcome to the Appium tutorial session 7. In this tutorial, we'll be looking into how you can scroll down in the application. So we are having some scenario where we have to scroll down. So suppose take it as example for contact list, you have a music library. You are take it as example for WhatsApp. This is a native app. We want to scroll down to some particular contact and you want to click on that. So how we can do that? So let's see the agenda for today. So initially we are having that scroll to and scroll to exact, these two methods in the earlier version of Appium. Okay, but currently these two version has been already been deprecated. So you see those method, if you use that, it won't be fruitful for us. Apart from that, we can also use the swipe functionality, but there is also some discrepancy with the swipe functionality. It's not able to scroll to the exact element sometimes I have found, and if you're using swipe, it also has been deprecated in the latest version of Appium. So how you can scroll in case of this native applications? So we'll be scrolling utilizing the JavaScript, and we can also scroll utilizing the find element by Android UI automator, and we'll be selecting the UI selector class. Okay, so let me show you one example that I will be scrolling down to my particular contact from my contact list, and I'll be clicking that contact to make a call and will disconnect the call. Okay, so let me take you to my clip first. Okay, this is my contact applications that have been automated. First, let me show you my device. This is my real device. I'm going operations. I'm using real device because it's pretty much faster than the emulator. Okay, so taking it to my contact. So this is my contact page. You can see, suppose I want to scroll to some particular contact. I want to make a call. How I can do that, right? So plus let me tell you what I've done in my contact applications test classes. So in the before class, I have taken the desired capabilities as a device name, new command time mode, app package and app activity. I have taken platform name, the version I'm going to operate, and the URL point where the application Appium server will run. Okay, and I've taken the Android driver that is instantiated from the Appium driver itself. And then the tear down, I've simply, if they have not equal to null, I'm destroying a test environment. Apart from it, I've mentioned to method, before method, that what are the method I'm going to execute. And after method, the method will print the method name and disclose the method. And this is my main class. A description I've written as a navigate to contact and call. So the screenshot part, skip it as of now. I am taking the screenshot of each and every pages. Okay, so skip that part. Okay, for scrolling, I am taking the scroll element classes. That object I have taken AC scroll element. For scrolling, I have created a one separate class that I have put in the under the utility packages scroll element. I have created the object AC, and we will be utilizing that object to scroll down a particular element. Let me first explain what I have done actually. So first, let me show you from. So this is my contact page. In the UI automotive here, I can see first I'm navigating to the contact page. I will validate that the contact option should be displayed. Okay, that contact text should be displayed. So first I'm navigating the contact, I'm verifying that this element is open or not. If this element found, that will print the title.getText page opened. And if no element found, then contact page failed to open. Then in the contact list, I have to find the contact list view. That the frame holding the contact list, all the contact list that I'm going to scroll. Let me show you. Suppose this one. So see, so the list view, we can see that okay. So the list view option, we can see that this is the form, this is the view actually we are going to operate. We are scrolling that element to the downside, to the down portions. And this is the main part we are going to scroll. Okay, so that from the list view, we can find easily find the package name and the class name and the resource ID. The class name android.widget.listview. Hold on. So I've taken the mobile contact list as a driver, finally went by ID com.android contact. Not this one, I guess. Okay, let me scroll it down. Linear layout. Yeah. Okay, I found it to the linear layout, the resource ID, the contact list view. So this layout, this not this one. So guys, you can see that there's a linear layout portions that marked indicators highlighted as red. So yeah, this is the actual layout page that we are going to perform the scroll operation, and we'll be scrolling down to find my find the contact I want to call. Okay, let me take you to my clips. Okay, this is my test class that I've written. So inside there I mention one method that mobile element target contact that AC dot scroll to element. AC is a object of that class. That class has been taken, scroll element class. Okay, so let me take you to my scroll element class first. Open the declarations. Okay, so for this calling to the particular contact, a particular text area, I have created one utility package class under the utility package, and the class name is scroll element. Inside that class, I have created three methods basically. This first one is constructor. I will be passing the IP Android driver as a parameter in the constructor itself. So the first method is a public mobile element scroll to elements. It's returning the element that if the text is fine, it will return that relevant element. Okay. So the Android element, I'm using the find element by Android UI automator. Then I'm using the new UI scrollable class. I'm considering the whole layout as a scrollable. And inside that, I'm taking one new UI selector class that is utilizing the scroll into view method to scroll it until and unless it found the string I want. Okay. So inside this call interview, I'm passing again the new selector classes along with the text that I've given as a string parameter in the method itself. So in that public mobile elements call to exact element, I'm passing two things, two like mobile element and string str. So mobile element is the layout that you are going to scroll, and string str inside that layout that you want to find some particular text. The same thing, I've created another method, the scroll to element. This will scroll to the particular element. The only difference is that this method will, if I provide some string, it will try to find the string inside that layout and while scrolling. If it is not fine, then it will give you there is no such element exceptions. And if you want to skip that, suppose one element contains some particular text. Here the difference is that I mentioned text contents, and for that I have given text only. So if you provide some text, that this text should be displayed, not the exact element text. So it will try to find and match the element while scrolling. And if it is fine, it will return as the element. So I've taken the return element. Okay. Another thing, we can also scroll stepwise. For stepwise call, we need to use the scroll forward class, and whatever the step I want to scroll, we can use. So skip this part later. We are having this two useful method. We can utilize this to scroll the all to scroll and scroll to my designated contact and perform some operation on it. So let's have a look into it. Let me navigate to my contact application page again. So what I'm doing actually, scroll to element. Scroll to elements means I'm passing the contact list mobile element string str. So I'm passing the contact list as a mobile element and call contact, whichever the target contact I'm using, target contact that I'm given as option from G option pane, this input I'm giving. I want to navigate this particular contact. Okay. So it's clicking the contact, then it's waiting for 2 seconds. Then after clicking the contact page should open like this. If I click on my contact, it's hanging. Let me show this. Let me connect my device again. Close. Okay, as if you click on some particular contact like this contact, so it will take you to this contact page, and in that contact page I'm considering this element that I'm going to call. So I'm selecting this element, I'm performing an action called a click. So if I click on that element, it will initiate the call. Next I'm disconnecting the call by action and element. This is the action and element, the red button. So first I'm navigating the target contact, then I'm performing the action call method, and then I'm performing the action end. I'm connecting the call. Along with for each and every operation, I am printing the same in the console output. Okay, and given the 2 second durations. Okay, so let me run my code first and let's have a look into it, how it's gonna operate. First I have to launch my Appium server. It will take some time, so let's wait for a while. Is opening my contact page and I should be expecting that pop-up should appear. Okay, I want to navigate to a XD pin. Let's see, just navigating to find the contact AXD pin. Okay, it's found that AXD pin, so it will click on that. So page got open successfully. Now we'll try to initiate the call. Okay, so call has been initiated, screenshot taken. Now we will disconnect the call. Okay, so we can see first of all, what is the opening? Navigating the contact page, then navigating the target contact. It's scrolling down to find the contact that given. It's capturing the screenshot and it's initiating the call. And after 2 seconds, it disconnecting the call. So my test script got passed, and for that, I think I also got the screenshot in my screenshot folder. Let me refresh it first. Calling page. Okay, that the screenshot has been taken. XD pin, navigating to the XD pin. So the same way the screenshot I have taken for this script. Okay, so let me recap you guys whatever I've done in this script. Inside the text, I'm navigating to this particular, scrolling to the particular element. For that I've created one separate class, scroll element class. Inside that class there is two method, mobile element, scroll to exact element and scroll to element. Okay, and in that inside the element I'm passing that mobile element and string I want to search. One more thing, if you don't want to use any utility class or package, this way you can directly embed the code inside your, and if you don't want to use that, so let me copy this same and let me paste it. In that case, I won't be using call to element contact. Okay, move it as of now. Mobile element target. Target contact equal to, that I'm going to paste here. Okay, it's Android element. Because see, if in this element I'll be passing as a contact list, let me copy the same contact list and str, the string str, what I'll be passing, the call to contact, that a text I'm gonna search. So the thing we are seeing that here we are not using any method, rather we are directly trying to find the target contact by calling to the contact list, and if the call contact, the target contact found, let me put it like it's fine. It will try to find the call contact, that particular contact I want to call. Let me name it as search contact. Copy paste. Okay. So first I'm searching, taking the string through the J option input pane, input dialog, and I want to search that particular contact inside that contact list. Okay, so if I run that, it will also operate the same way. Let me open my let me provide XD pin. Okay, so guys, we have seen that if you don't want to use any method, use the method directly, you can pass the same that we are finding the mobile element, target element. We are passing the search contact string text here, and we are using the contact list that we are going to scroll. So this way you can find the contact. Okay. And if you want to find all the contact list in your contact applications, that we can also do. I will try to cover this in my next tutorial. How to print all the contact list here, all the music list in your music library, contact list in your contact here, all the elements in your some particular native app. We can also utilize the same to print the same in the control console list output. Okay. So guys, that's all for today. So utilizing that call to extract element by using the find element by andorid UI automator class and using the new UIScrollable. Scroll into view, we can search the particular string inside that layout, and we can navigate to that, and we can perform some operation on it. Okay, so that's all for today, guys. If you have any questions regarding the scrolling, you can just comment in the below sections. I will respond to your comment. So that's all for today. Thank you for watching.